Yo, what's up everyone? This is K Collections and today I'll be doing a video on the three awesome tools to use before Gudaguda, and of course this is for Fate Grand Order, the NA version. And as you guys can already tell, this is from GamePress. You may or may not use this website already. Me personally, I love this, and I just want to start off by saying I'm not receiving any benefit whatsoever by talking about their tools and this website in general. It's just something I personally love. This is actually my main go-to for Fate Grand Order and Fire Emblem Heroes. So let's get started. The first tool I want to talk about is the Servant Planner. As I said previously on my Gudaguda guide video, we're going to receive so many materials to upgrade our servants. And this is a great planner to see which materials you need to upgrade a specific skill. So let's say, for example, you got Emiya out of the Okita banner, right? And of course, he's going to start at level 1. Let's say you want to upgrade Mind's Eye. Just input the skill's current level right here and your target. So for the sake of this example, let's say you want to maximize Mind's Eye. And all you got to do is calculate. And these are all the materials you need to really maximize that specific skill. So this is a great way to see which materials you want to prioritize and how much QP you need. So for this, you need a little bit over 27 million, which is honestly quite a lot. You may or may not already have it. But the Servant Planner is an excellent tool to use, and you can also check out all his other skills. Let's say you want to also increase this and projection magecraft, okay? And you want to go to level 4 with it, and for projection magecraft, level 7. And for Mind's Eye, you want to go to level 5. Just go to calculate again, and there you go. That's all you need to maximize what you input. I also forgot to mention, you can see which ascension materials you need when leveling up your character. So let's say you want to level up Vlad, okay, and you want him to be at, well, let's say he's at level 1 and you want him to be at level 50. You can now see which materials or how many experience cards you need and QP you need to really ascend him that far. And let's say you want him to be at level 100, you want to max grail him. That's all the ascension items you need, and of course, it has this ascension artwork, the amount of experience, QP, and how many grails you need. So, very excellent tool right there. And for example, let's say Vlad is like your absolute favorite character and you want to maximize all his skills as well. Okay, I'm just clicking anything, so don't mind me. 10, 10, and 10, and calculate, right? Now that's all the materials you need to ascend him, to max skill him, to max grail him, and that's that's a lot of QP, to be honest. But that's how much you need to really unlock your servant's true potential, if you want to call it like that. So an excellent tool to use, definitely use this to plan ahead before Gudaguda. Moving on to the second tool, this is the Summon Simulator, and I know a lot of players already use this tool, but for newer players or casual players who doesn't know about this, this is an awesome way to test your luck, and they actually updated the Gudaguda pickup banner, and simply, you just choose the banner you want. In this case, I'm going to choose the Gudaguda to try to get Okita, and just scroll down and click Summon, and oh man, that's freaking amazing. If only that were real life, holy shit, I'll be freaking happy. So I just wanna let you guys know. keep your expectations in check. Sometimes you get a pull like this and you think you're the luckiest person in the world, but when you pull at the actual game, you get nothing but salt. So just be very careful. From my experience with the simulator, it's more or less accurate in terms of percentage. I guess I just had EX luck with this fake simulator. But this is a great way to see which servant you're probably going to get, especially on the raid up for 3-star servants. Like you can see right here, I got Ku, the stupid freaking clown that I still hate. And you keep summoning. And also it tells you down here how many sync cords you use, an average of the money spent. And you can pull again, right? Second pull, nothing but salt. Got some 3-star exclusive craft essence. Now let's say I want to pull again, 3 10 shots, 90 sync cords used, and I got a 5-star craft essence, right? So this is honestly a great tool to use to really check your luck, to see what you're going to pull, and you could go ham, you go crazy, right? So I just went I just start clicking like crazy, and that's 500 sync cords used, almost $300, and that's why I pull, right? That's just irritating right now. My first 10 shot on this fake simulator. I know for the real game, I'm going to have the shittiest luck, but whatever. It is what it is. That's why I said, keep your expectations in check. This is a phenomenal tool to use, and if you want to reset, clearly, just click the reset button, and you could restart it, okay? And summon, see what you get. Nothing but salt right there. Summon again. Nothing. Again. Still nothing. Again. Again. And I got Dayon, right? So, great tool to use, and have fun with it. Now, the last tool to use is the experience calculator. And again, it's pretty self-explanatory. You just input your current skill level for a servant. Let's say for me, I have Hercules. This is actually true. My Hercules is only level 70, okay? And let's say I want to max scale him to level 100. And all I gotta do is go to calculate, and that's how much experience I needed in total. And that's how many, you know, essentially experience cards I need to really maximize this level. Of course, it says right here, no 4-star experience. I need no 451, in this case, Berserker class card. For non-Berserker class, you know, I need this much for 3-star experience, 2 stars, and 1 star. Let's say I pull Okita, right? You guys saw my simulator. Let's say I got Okita, and of course, she's going to be at level 1, and I want to put her into level 60. What I gotta do is calculate, and that's how many cards I need. Right, let's say I want to go to 90, you know, let's say, you know, that's the level I want her to be, and that's how much experience cards I need, all right? So, again, this is a great way to, you know, determine how many experience cards you need to save up, which experience card you want to save or burn, because I know for me, personally, I do occasionally burn my 3-star experience cards just for some mana prisms, and, yeah, this is, again, a very useful tool for ascending your servants, right? Because we're gonna receive so many ascension items, so you just want a rough estimate of how many experience cards you need to really maximize their level, okay? So, I definitely hope these were useful. Let me know if you use them already. Let me know if you're new to this website and you're starting to use these tools and if it was helpful whatsoever. If you like this video, hit the like button and comment down below. Are you excited for Gudaguda? You know, which servant are you going to ascend first and maximize your level or skill with? And yeah, you know, I definitely enjoy talking to you guys about Fate Grand Order. I had a blast with my previous videos. You know, thank you so much for the new subscribers I've gained. You guys are awesome. So subscribe to my channel. I'll do a lot more Fate Grand Order videos. And by chance, if you are a toy collector, you know, I am reviewing figures, you know, scale anime figures, Funko Pops, you name it. And just keep this in mind, guys. Have fun with this event. It's gonna be a huge blast. And till next time, guys, have an awesome day.